All right, y'all, the success of one of my favorite players in baseball, Shohei Ohtani, has got me mesmerized. I'm wondering if there's anybody else out there who could be a two-way star like Ohtani. Now, check this out. One of my other favorite players, Noah Syndergaard, the big man himself, I think has a chance to be that. And I believe he's actually I think he would be better served in the American League, where he could both DH and pitch just like Ohtani, right? So we know what he's about, right? Big man throwing gas. Look at this. Oh, a little bit of late movement. Now, I love this man's throwing motion. Now, check this out right here. Everything's congruent, very casual, right? On the pickup, very casual. Now, look at this. It's like almost like in football when you're varying your speed. I like how casual it is to the pickup, but then the delivery is extremely violent, man. Check that out right there. Look at that. Oh, look at the stretch, right? Look at the stretch in that bad boy. Look at where the hand, right? The hand placement. You can see where it breaks from the glove. Look at the turnover. Look at the, oh my God, this dude is just an absolute perfect thrower. He's what I call a thrower pitcher. It's almost like in boxing when they call you a boxer puncher. He can both throw and pitch. So he's got a crazy repertoire and everything like that. Let's get to some more of that. All right, now check this one out right here. Oh, breaking ball on curveball. Got his ass. Look, same thing right here. You want to make everything look the same. Some of these people, when they go to their off-speed stuff, they start flailing around and telegraphing it and everything like this. His looks exactly the same no matter what. Look at the turnover. Look at that. It still looks like some straight heat is coming, some straight gas. But look at it fall off a cliff. Oh, yeah, my man reaching hard. Look at him. He used all of his muscle fiber to try to get the ball way out there on the outside of the plate. Nope. Oh. All right, last one right here. You know what's coming. You got Joey Votto right there. Difficulty of task, definitely a 10. A choked up Joey Votto. And, oh, high heat. Now look at Votto. He's like, huh? What was that? All right, you already know what it is right here. Now look at the location of this. Ooh, look at the movement on that bad boy. Look at the framing by Wilson Ramos right there. Votto may have a case, but man, you gotta give it to him. Nice framing, nice pitch. Look at Votto. He's like, Okay. All right, let's check out my man going yard on him. Ooh, come on, let's rewind that back right there. All right, let's check out the swing. All right, so he has a nice mid lift in his front leg. Look at that. The hips start rotating way before. Love it. Look how much hip rotation and torque he's getting, right? Ball almost out over the plate. He's going to hit that bad boy late and catch it real late, right on the barrel. Oh, look at that. I love that swing, man. You can't tell me this guy couldn't be a DH if all else failed. Look at the release on it. I love it. So he has one of those stand-up releases. Stand-up release. Doesn't go all the way back. Keeps it kind of half-cocked right there. Not like the King Griffey where that bad boy would come all the way down and hit the ground. But definitely a good swing. This is your pitcher, guys. Man, I wish he played in the American League. Now, don't get me wrong. I love the Mets. I love him playing for the Mets and everything like that. But come on. This guy wouldn't be fun to watch. Maybe like pitch, and then a couple of days later, you can put him at the DH. He launched that bad boy too. Damn, where did it go? Crazy. Let's see if we can see it from another angle. All right. One last time right here. Got in a super slow-mo. See the mid kick, the mid lift right there. Hip rotation. So definitely a power base, lower half base power swing. Oh, look how far back he catches it. Ooh, look how it comes off the bat. Oh, look at the ricochet. Man, he could even got more into it. Check out where he hit it at in the lift off of it. That's a powerful human being, y'all. So let me know right there in the comment section. Do you think this guy has what it takes if he were to be traded to an American League team or were to eventually end up in an American League team within the next however many years? I think he's still relatively young. Do you think that he could be like Shohei Ohtani and become a designated hitter in the American League, right? A pitcher and a designated hitter. Or maybe just later in his career, who did that? Maybe Rick Ankiel, somebody like that, became just a hitter? I don't know. Definitely wouldn't want to not see him throwing with those pitches that he has and those late breaking pitches and those breaking balls and curves. And, of course, that fastball. But I think he adds a lot of value to the plate if he were to concentrate on just hitting, right? Imagine he's spending off season just hitting. A big, strong guy like that, man. What, he's like 6'5", maybe like 235, 240 or something like that. Come on now. All right? But just let me know. Thank you for watching.